What is interesting to me about the sheet metal work is we take flat pieces of the metal and we can lay them out, we can cut them, we can roll them, we can bend them, we can weld them together, and we could create a multitude of shapes and forms.
What I enjoy about the craft is being able to work with my hands, having to use my head. You know, we have to measure. Sometimes there's changes that have to be made and you got to do them on the spot. So it's a challenge. It's good to have a challenge. Every day is something different. So it's good, you know, exercise for your brain.
I'm using a drift pin and a pair of vice grips. And what this is doing is lining up my holes for my carriage bolts for us to bolt the duct together. Without this, it would be pretty difficult to line up our two connections. You get to work with a lot of good journeymen over the years, and they pass down a lot of trade secrets and stuff that they've learned over the years, and it's what we pass down to our apprentices when they start. And, you know, we all take a pride in our job.
I tell my kids that I come to work and do something new every day, use my hands, and it's something that we're gonna be able to see, or as far as the structures that we're working on. And something to be proud of, something you could say you worked on. And it's, you know, it's a good, honest living. Something I try to preach to my children.
Where he worked at before, every day, you know, he'd wear, he'd dress up every single day. When he would come home from work before, he'd be like, so how was work today? Oh, I don't want to talk about it. And now it's like, we're like, okay, already. He's so proud of like what he's doing. And that makes me happy too.
I have two boys and I tell them, you know, working with your hands, it's a sense of accomplishment because you feel like you're making a difference. You know, like you actually make things and you see them operating like we see our duct operating. And it's a big sense of accomplishment.
I think my dad's like, it's crazy the stuff he does, working on like all the way up there. I couldn't do that, I don't think. I don't know. I'm proud of him, yeah.
His hands used to be like silk. I mean, seriously, like, and now every day there's just new cuts and new things. And I mean, it's sad at the same time, but it just, I'm also just so proud of him that he just, I don't even know how to describe it. It's just, it's neat for us. It's really, it's awesome.
I'm proud that he's taking the time to learn everything. Like, he enjoys doing it, and it shows commitment, like how he just wants to learn everything and do it right.
You have to help out your coworkers, learn from your coworkers, and just try your best all the time. And so when you give your best, it's gonna show to your boss, to your foreman, to your coworkers that they can trust you. And you need trust from your coworkers to know that they can depend on you.
Everything he does for us, you know, he does it because he loves us.
Because I left a job where I had no benefits at all. I had no medical, I had no pensions, I didn't have good pay. And so I see the benefits working for the sheet metal trade as far as helping my family, and it's I could really see the benefits now.
Back in the days, they had storytelling to tell the different history that went on. So sheet metal is a way of telling a story, but you're telling it with your hands and with the objects you create.
You have to be able to see the big picture before it's even created. And to me, that's being artistic. But to the average person, I don't really know too much if they would think it's a beautiful thing. But for us, it is, because this is what we do for a living. This is what we take pride in.
Here, I drew a line where I have to cut the dimension, and I'm using these double cuts, and I gotta make sure I make a straight line. So the brain's working with the eye, with the hand. So good hand-eye coordination, it's pretty amazing. Some things that just happen naturally when you don't even expect them to happen. It just, when you need it to get it done, it gets done.
We sculpt this, we have to build it, and we have to design it, and it's gotta look clean, it's gotta have nice lines, everything's gotta flow. It's definitely beautiful to me because we make it. All right.
No, give me a screw on that side too, in the middle. Give me one.
The relationship between the apprentice and the journeyman, trying to learn everything that I can from him.
When he's right, you can say, I did this, and then you're proud when you say it.
So on a construction site, you're in the zone, you're getting it done, and you want to make sure that it's to the best of your ability, because you know that when you walk away, that's going to be there for a very long time.
Okay, we got our lengths right here, our piece numbers, we got our fan coil numbers, we got our elevations, these are our column lines, that's where a lot of our measurements are taken from. You got to know how this stuff goes in, you can't just throw it up in the air wherever you want to. Everything is per design. That's why they teach us in the apprenticeship how to read blueprints, because there's a lot more to this stuff than people think.
It's always an adventure, always something new. You work with different people, do different things. You put your mind to work most of the time, and you get to learn from all these other guys that are in the trades. My hands?
Yeah.
I see hard-earned money that I make with these hands. That's it.
Easy.
Huh? Yeah. Ready.
Those are working man's hands.
Yeah, exactly.
It's nice to see the various aspects of the sheet metal industry that our members perform. Not only the heating, ventilating, and air conditioning work, the humongous duct work that is going through there, the very large exhaust fans that are going through that building, the kitchens, the stainless steel work, and I can see the pride in my members' eyes when I ask them about the work they're performing at the Wilshire Grand.
Seeing all these different size fittings, whether they're round or rectangular, all the different bends and different applications, it's amazing what you could do with some flat sheet of metal. I take pride in knowing some of those people, especially to work for someone like Caesar. They obviously sacrificed and, you know, laid the path for us for the future.
So these are the typical office floors from level 11 to level 29. And pretty much what we're doing is the core. So we're going from floor to floor, installing all the duct mains. We're setting the air handler units and running our outside air ducts to the louvers.
I'm a builder since day one. So, I mean, I'm continuing the tradition as a builder. And I love meeting the challenges and expectations that this job poses.
My children, my grandchildren, their children are going to see this. They're going to know that their grandfather was part of this project. Part of this great project for many, many years to come.
You got to be hungry to learn new things, be excited to come to work every day, and have a good attitude. Attitude is key in anything you do, and especially in this trade, attitude is key.
When I look at these hoods, you can look at all the detail in all the brake lines, all the radiuses. These are all handcrafted from pieces of sheet metal.
So this is the kind of work, though, that, you know, when we're trying to, you know, recruit or talk to some of the younger people about getting into the sheet metal trade, you know, we talk about the different aspects of our industry, because we do a lot, right? We do kitchen equipment, we do HVAC, we do general sheet metal, architectural sheet metal, industrial, you know, welding. Yeah. And so, you know, we talk to them and we show them things like this, like, hey, this is what you could be doing. You could be fabricating this, you'll learn how to do it in school, and then you'll be installing it out in the field,
yeah.
You know. And so when they actually see it, it resonates more, because they can see they're actually going to be fabricating something, and then they see the final application of it.
Luther, look at the quality and the workmanship on the exhaust here. Mm-hmm. Everything fits perfectly. And look at the detail on all the brake lines. Everything matches up from one hood to another. Everything's detailed properly.
So it's too bad it's overcast out there, because you'd be able to see the ocean, right?
Yeah.
So here we are at the iconic Wilshire Grand, on the top, on the 73rd floor, up on the roof, overlooking the beautiful city of Los Angeles. This is a culmination of work, of skilled craftsmanship, not only by the sheet metal workers, but by all of the affiliates, all of the construction unions that are out here. Everybody working together to get this job done, and done on time, done correctly. It's just awe-inspiring. It's very inspirational to be able to come out here and see what our craftsmen and women are doing, and the skill level, discipline, motivation, and dedication that they perform day in and day out when they're on the job.